Misunderstandings about overcharging of mobile phones are common. Most devices are smart enough to stop charging after being fully charged, just charge as needed to maintain 100%. First of all, let us understand what happens when phone is charged overnight. As the phone starts running on its own fully charged battery, it consumes power. Even if you are on standby or active standby mode, there will come a point in time when your battery decreases to 99%. Now, according to basic rules of phones follows, it should allow the battery to charge if the battery is less than 100%. Hence, the phone starts charging again. So, this cycle of hopping between 99% and 100% creates a problem for your smartphone. Please note that it is not 99% for all the smartphones. Some smartphones start charging only when the battery reaches to a level of 90%, and this figure varies for different devices, but the differences in these figures are not huge. Nowadays, every phone is made of lithium-ion batteries. Li-ion, lithium-ion, as the name suggests, are ions which performs best when ions keep moving freely as much as they can. Hence, charging your device in short spurts throughout the day will give ions enough thermal energy to keep them moving. This will definitely ensure the longest battery life possible. If you want to understand how lithium-ion batteries fail, you can find the video in the description section. Thermal runaway is a process in which when at critical temperatures the materials inside these batteries start to break down exothermically, so they generate a lot of heat while they break down, and when heat cannot escape as fast as it's being generated, this is a runaway reaction that cannot be stopped. And that why see so much high-profile incidents reported in the press associated with lithium-ion battery failure. So the point is that heat needs to escape as fast as it's being generated. Prolonged charging can also lead to an increased temperature, which naturally degrades your battery. It can also be dangerous in extreme cases, especially if you keep your phone under your pillow. Don't leave your device under your pillow at all if you can help it. The lack of airflow not only means potential damage to your battery, but also increases the risk of fire. So the question is what you can do? 1. You need to avoid exposing your phone to any extremes. Temperatures below 32 Fahrenheit, which is 0 degrees Celsius, and above 158 Fahrenheit, which is 70 degrees Celsius, because this can degrade your Li-ion battery faster. Don't sunbathe with your phone heating up beside you, and don't leave it in your car on a hot or cold day either. 2. You shouldn't use your device for any high-intensity activities while it's charging. Realistically, many people do. Nonetheless, regularly doing so can cause irreparable damage, but checking your messages or emails should be fine. Just don't do anything that takes a lot of energy. 3. Avoid charging from 0 to 100%. Avoid extremes to extend your battery life. Partial charges and discharges that combine to 100% count as a single full cycle. By partially charging and discharging between 20 and 80%, you could get 1,000 full cycles or more before hitting a noticeable drop in capacity. That's almost 3 years of daily charges. 4. Never put your smartphone under direct sunlight, again because of temperature issues. The problems occur when the battery overheats, which can cause damage. To avoid this, it's best to remove any case on your phone when charging overnight. It's also best to leave the phone on a flat, hard surface so the heat can dissipate easily. So in brief, it will damage the battery on the long run. In order to have long battery life, it is advised not to fully charge the battery. Lithium-ion batteries have 400 charge cycle. That is, charging your smartphone device from 0% to 100% is considered as one complete cycle. So it's better if you do partial charging, which will increase the health of the battery. In the short term, you may not notice much difference, but you'll be happy when your phone still survives a full day on a single charge after a year. Give us a like if you found this video helpful, and share it with your friends, and especially to them who charge them overnight. And let us know in the comment section how do you charge your batteries. And don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.